So the approach to diagnose systemic lupus is complicated in the sense that you need to look at the entire picture of a patient's presentation and their laboratory workup. The two go together. You can't really make a diagnosis just based on a clinical presentation if the laboratories don't fit. There are many reasons why somebody may lose hair. There are many reasons why somebody may develop a rash that was triggered by sunlight. There are many things that can cause a presentation similar to lupus, and that's what makes the diagnosis a challenge, always. The most common misconception in lupus is that the diagnosis can be made just based on an antibody called ANA, or anti-nuclear antibody. This is a screening test for lupus. It's commonly done in the outpatient setting, and many patients believe they have the disease just based on the ANA. About a third of healthy adults in the United States have a positive anti-nuclear antibody. The presence of this test alone does not mean that you have a systemic autoimmune disease. So having a positive ANA alone is never equivalent to a diagnosis of systemic lupus. The markers that patients are often concerned about is having positive autoantibodies like double-stranded DNA and low complements or having low blood counts. Even though these are markers of low disease activity, they are not targeted by treatment. So a doctor may not be able to give you a medication to get rid of these. If they are not accompanied by a clinical sign that your disease is active, meaning swollen joints, fevers, protein in the urine, and so on, alone, those do not require changes in management. There are many reasons why the commonly accepted markers in other inflammatory diseases like CRP or sedimentation rate are elevated in lupus. They may be elevated because you're having an infection. They may be elevated because a patient is overweight or obese. So again, all of them need to be taken in context. So there's no gold standard laboratory marker that will tell us that we must change treatment unless it's a sign of kidney activity. But in general, the commonly accepted markers of disease activity like CRP, ESR always need to be taken in context and alone are not a target of treatment. The diagnosis of lupus is additive, so I may not be able to see everything that the patients experienced before. They may have had rashes in the past, so it's important to understand what kind of rashes they were. Were they rashes that go away within an hour? Was this a facial rash that occurs when they're emotional or they eat spicy food? Many times these facial rashes are interpreted as being the so-called malar rash in lupus, which is a inflammatory rash occasionally triggered by sun that lasts for days, not really related to emotions or spicy food or so, because that is mostly rosacea. Painful joints versus swelling, right? So sometimes patients complain of a lot of pain in their hands or in different joints of their body that's triggered by activity. They do things at home, they lift something heavy, they develop pain, they rest, it goes away. So that is a typical mechanical pain that is never a sign of lupus. Lupus causes stiffness, pain at rest. So all the symptoms need to be questioned further.